Okay, so what we did is we ran differences between the male respondents and the female respondents. We're also breaking it down in other ways as well. And we can look at differences between their years of experience. We can look at differences between where they are and the level of the organization, so all great things. But one thing that Rebecca pointed out is that we did see differences between perception of men and women when it comes to D&I in the workplace. So here's what, these are our respondents. So this is our results, is that 26% of women have seen gender bias always or often in their organizations, compared to 10% of our male respondents, which was a statistically significant difference. And I think this is important because throughout, when it came to D&I, we did see differences between men and women. So this was, then we wanted to find out, well, have you personally experienced bias in the workplace? So then when we asked the question, 16% of women have said they personally experienced bias always or often. So that means one in six of our respondents, 6.5 of respondents, compared to 4% of men. And then we also asked questions in terms of frequency. So 1/3 of our respondents said sometimes, compared to 12% of men who had personally experienced bias. Okay, so we also, and this isn't all just men versus women, just to make it very clear, we asked questions about skills and leadership, which we will get into, but we also wanted to see what else have you seen based on gender and experienced yourselves. So we gave a list of just markers that we took from the research. There's a great study called Fixing the Flawed Approach to Diversity, and we use that as a guide to apply to the industry, because so far in our industry, there's not a lot of research looking at differences between women and men in PR. Sometimes it's packaged with other areas like advertising or journalism, so we wanted to separate this. So half of our respondents say that in terms of their career that they have experienced pay discrimination compared to 6% of men. The other ones that were the big ones were ideas not taken seriously and talked over in a meeting or dismissal of input. And that was 6 out of 10 of our respondents had that. And then the other interesting marker at the bottom was sexual harassment, which is pretty severe in terms of, you know, the workplace. And that was 1 in 3 of our female respondents said they had. And one in 10 of our male respondents said they had also experienced sexual harassment. All right, so then we ask a perception gap. We wanted to say, well, how do you think your organization is doing in terms of D&I? And I thought the results were very interesting because what we saw frequently is that, oh, this is a 1 to 5 scale, 5 is strongly agree. So the higher the score, the more they agree. Most of this was positive. So for example, my company supports women in advancement opportunities. On a 1 to 5 scale, the mean was 4.32 for men versus 3.84 for women. Now in every case, that you see that the means for the men, the perception was higher than the means for women. And they were all statistically significant differences. The one that you see, there are obstacles to diversity and inclusion in my company, right? Look at that. I mean, that men had that to be, or the means were lower, but just look at the mean scores. When you're at a 3 scale, that is a neutral point. In this term, we said neither agree nor disagree. So when you look at this and you say 2.99, which is, that's the midpoint range, and a 3.22 is the midpoint range. What I thought was also really interesting and overall, not even just men to women differences, is the company's leadership reflects the diversity of its employees. And you see, those are also low scores, regardless if you're a man or a woman. They're just overall low. And this is an issue that we, as the Diversity Action Alliance, have talked about. I'll just tell you just a quick conversation I had with a big vendor in our industry, and they were telling me about all the great D&I efforts. And I was like, yeah, but your leadership, like 11 out of 12 are white men. And they said, yeah, but we just brought Judith on board. And I'm like, okay. I was like, but it's really hard, because if you're telling me that you really care about this, but your leadership doesn't reflect what your initiatives are internally and what your chief diversity officer is telling me, then it's really problematic. And then you can also see some of the other low points was my company has visible role models who represent diversity and leadership. And that's also a big marker for people of color in the Fixing the Flawed Approach to Diversity workspace. That was like one of the top for people of color, what was important to them. And then Rebecca's going to talk about what men and women say they're going to do to advance their careers.
So when it comes to managing their own careers, I think one of the common refrains that we always hear about women is that we all have to lean in a little harder, that we need to learn a bit more about business negotiations and advocating for ourselves in our careers. But what was really interesting about what we saw here is that clearly, women are very proactive about advancing their careers, including asking for pay increases, negotiating positions, and making work work for them, often in higher rates than men. And just for a moment, I thought we would take a second to talk about money, right? We saw an interesting deviation in the perception of pay gaps and fairness around compensation. So what's up here is that nearly half of female respondents believe that men make a higher salary than women in a similar cohort, compared to only 10% of men who would say the same, right? Meanwhile, more than half of men say everyone who's the same gets paid the same, compared with just over a quarter of women who believe that to be true. Statistically, we know that a gender pay gap exists, right? Addressing potential pay and policy gaps is an essential part of this conversation, creating gender equality, and there's a huge call to action there. And when it comes to perception gaps, like we can see, you know, exposed here, much of that discrepancy could be eliminated through more transparency around salaries and demystifying compensation structures. Now, taking a closer look at the steps people are taking to advance their careers, what we thought the interesting storyline here is that men and women are managing their careers almost identically. So if you look at, you know, the left-hand column and the right, taking on additional responsibilities to prove their value, seeking out challenges and taking risks, and raising their visibility. One interesting point of departure worth noting is that men and women report different approaches to moving up in an organization. So more women report asking for a promotion, while men are seeking competitive offers to position themselves for bigger opportunities.